All that matters is the title. And to be frank, barring a major injury, this team won't have much of a chance against the Lakers or even the Clippers, for that matter. June 27th, 2013.
Kevin Garnett, Paul Pierce, Jason Terry, all going to the Brooklyn Nets. Celtics get three number ones, 2014, 2016, 2018. Humphries, Wallace, Evans, just a bunch of stuff.
This turned out to be maybe the most disastrous trade in NBA history. As the Nets fell apart soon after, the Boston Celtics would cash in.
The Boston Celtics select Jaylen Brown.
The Boston Celtics select Jason Tatum.
7.5 years later, and the Nets are once again bargaining their future to bring in another big name. Is this another trade doomed for failure, or will it be the move that gets the franchise its first ever NBA championship? First, it's important to get the full picture of the trade for the Nets. What they brought in is simple, a former MVP and six-time member of the All-NBA first team in James Harden. What they gave up? Three of their own unprotected first-round picks, the Bucks' 2022 first-round pick, as well as four pick swaps. They also gave away Caris LeVert, Jared Allen, Rodions Kurucs, and Taurean Prince. That is a whole lot to give away, not only looking at the draft capital, but also pretty much all of their depth. Now, the Nets will have no choice but to count on guys like Timothy Luwawu-Cabarrot, Bruce Brown, and Reggie Perry to give them good minutes off the bench. It also puts a lot of pressure on the aging DeAndre Jordan as the only true center on the entire roster. The biggest question that has to be answered for the Nets is where will the defense come from? They were already having some issues on that end, and now they've traded away their top rim protector. And Harden has definitely improved from what he used to be on D, but a backcourt of Kyrie Irving and James Harden is still a backcourt of Kyrie Irving and James Harden. Opposing guards will be licking their chops. So then how about on offense? Theoretically, they should be pretty unstoppable. They have three absolute stars who are most known for being scoring machines, and they will definitely figure it out at some point, but I think there could be some growing pains. You have to believe there's going to be some diminishing returns in adding isolation scores. Harden has had the most isolation possessions for six straight seasons, and by quite a bit each year, while Durant and Irving pretty consistently find themselves in the top 10, and all three of them do it with great efficiency. Now, having two great ISO scorers is awesome, there's no doubt, because when one is sitting, the other can stay on and lead an efficient offense with little to no help. But how much value is really gained from adding a third? All of these guys are incredibly efficient anyway, so if you're just going to give some of Irving and Durant's ISO possessions to Harden instead, you're not really going to gain a whole lot. And with the background of head coach Steve Nash, who was the main cog in the historic 7 seconds or less Suns offense of the 2000s, I doubt he wants the offense to be endless isolations. The key will be getting all of these players working off ball. Durant did a solid bit of this in Golden State, especially cutting to the basket. Irving has done some off ball stuff throughout his career, but not a ton. And Harden, well, in the last few seasons when he hasn't had the ball, he just straight up wouldn't move. Now, he did have to carry a big load on the Rockets, and that could explain him taking some possessions off, because Harden, like Durant and Irving, are all amazing shooters and very, very capable of playing off the ball. And if they do all buy in, there is absolutely no reason why this can't be the most explosive offense we have ever seen in the history of the league. At the end of the day, for the Nets, this trade will be graded on one simple thing. Did they win a championship? It only takes one, and if they get it, anything else that happens won't matter. But if they don't, the trade will go down as another awful blemish on the Nets' history and will once again handcuff the team for years to come. One thing that would help in the quest for that championship would be having as many years together as possible. Harden still has another year after this one before he can become a free agent, while Durant and Irving are locked in until at least 2023. But in today's NBA, that doesn't quite mean what it used to. These days, stars can seemingly force themselves onto other teams whenever they please, and with three big personalities, all with healthy egos, there's no telling just how long this core will stay together. So what are their chances of winning a championship this season? I do think the Nets have a good shot to get out of the East, but as I said, that doesn't matter. All that matters is the title. And to be frank, barring a major injury, this team won't have much of a chance against the Lakers or even the Clippers, for that matter. There's just no depth and not enough defense. The LA teams are built well enough to be able to sustain the sheer firepower from the Nets. But fear not, Brooklyn fans. While you may not have the assets to pick up the depth guys you want this season, you will learn that the offseason for a contender can be a beautiful thing. Guys want to win, especially in the latter part of their career, and they're willing to sign for a whole lot less to have a chance at doing so. We saw this with the Warriors and Cavs, and more recently with the Clippers and the Lakers. So I have no doubt that by next season, the Nets will have all the tools in place to truly contend. And as far as that 2013 trade goes, there were some key differences for sure. Harden is 31 years old. Pierce and Garnett, they were both over 35. Beyond that, the superstar they had acquired a year earlier in Deron Williams inexplicably forgot how to play basketball shortly after the trade, which ultimately was a much bigger part of the Nets' implosion than either Pierce or Garnett. So is the trade worth it? All you have to do is look at the last two seasons to realize that yes, it is.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please drop a like, share it with your friends, and subscribe to Lingo Sports and Lingo News for a whole lot more just like this.